Micah Abernathy, the two deep men. This will be returned from the three, Evan Berry. Nice return out near the 28-yard line. And it's time to introduce the cow. Chick-fil-A starting lineups, and that leads us to the senior Josh Dobbs. Multifaceted young man. He's 6'3", 210, an aerospace engineering major. 20 total TDs this season, but as Gary said, he's dropped it a few times.
He has, but he's the whole offense. They're going to start Hurd and Kamara in the backfield. Not a surprise.
Sweep to the left is Kamara. And a nice first down gain after the 35-yard line. Eddie Jackson made the stop.
I think it's a good play to get Jalen Hurd back in the game. Number one is going to lead the play and gets a good block on the edge. A positive play to start out for both running backs.
Now, Hurd sat out last week with an undisclosed injury. And Kamara just had a brilliant game. Here's Dobbs in trouble, but he can't escape it, as you see. And he's got his tight end open at the 50 for the first down. Ethan Wolf, number 82.
Listen, we've been watching him three straight weeks. He basically demoralizes defenses when he does this. You've got to stop, and all of a sudden he's on the outside, the perimeter, and he delivers a first down.
That is a gain of 16, and they are across midfield. Sweep right side, Jalen Hurd. And let's introduce you to the remainder of the Tennessee offense. Some changes up front where Bulware gets a start. And so does Coleman Thomas, Dylan Wiseman, and Jayshon Robertson, both out with injuries.
First substitution for Tennessee in the game, and Alabama matches it with the substitution themselves.
Second down three. Dobbs, pressured. Comes right side, dropped. Jason Kroon, who dropped a couple last week. Alabama's defense, Allen Payne Tomlinson and Anderson up front. Minka Fitzpatrick at Arkansas last week. Three interceptions, one of which he returned for a 100-yard touchdown. They did, that defensive unit for Alabama, give up 400 yards passing last week. Third down.
Here's the ball game right here for Tennessee. Can they win third down?
Four-man rush. Kamara hangs on to it. That should be enough to move the chain.
It's the same play they scored the touchdown against Georgia right here. Kamara in the slot. A slight pick that could have been called from the outside receiver. Picks it out, and Kamara is such a good receiver as a running back. Returns punts, obviously.
Dobbs keeps it, and he is trapped. Dropped for a loss. Ryan Anderson, first man there.
Werner, so many difficult things to do against this Alabama defense, but maybe the toughest is to get outside them in the running game. They set the edge as good as anybody in college defense, and they've been doing it for as long as Nick has been at Alabama.
Loss of three. Josh Malone, top of the screen. They're three wide to the left. Here's the pass coming near, and Ryan Anderson, I think, got a hand on it and knocked it away from Kamara. So third and 13. And again, they'll go three wide left, two to the right. The inside man on the right side is Jawan Jennings. He is up on the line of scrimmage, and they'll bump and run with him. Now Hurd in the backfield. Third and 13. Fourth and a mile. Tim Williams, pass rushing specialist, number 56. That's his fourth and a half sack this season.
Well, if Myles Garrett isn't the best pass rusher, and if Derek Barnett isn't the best pass rusher, This guy is the best pass rusher. Comes off the edge, four-man rush, just takes the inside move, gets inside Chance Hall, and it's no contest.
That will leave it up to Trevor Daniel to punt on fourth down.
He has been a weapon for Tennessee.
Into the end zone, touchback. A 58-yard punt. Stars are shining not over Alabama, they're shining in Tennessee, or they will be in about 5 hours. Introduce you to the Chick-fil-A offense for Alabama, and that means we start inside that group with Jalen Hurts, the freshman quarterback.
Well, if you can imagine, Vern, a true freshman quarterback coming onto a team that won a national championship and beating out other five-star quarterbacks. It's just not like they had nobody there in competition. And he wins the job, and he leads them to the undefeated season so far.
There's a little toss on the sweep. This goes to Ardarius Stewart. And he's out to the 26-yard line. Offensively for Alabama, Robinson, Pierce Baker, Bozeman, Lester Cotton replaces Alphonse Taylor at right guard. Taylor will not play because of a concussion, which was not described as an extra upper body extremity. Hurts keeps it. He's a dual threat quarterback.
He is, Vern. Get this. Jalen Hurts has started two games in the SEC on the road, Ole Miss and Arkansas. He is 32 for 48 in those games combined, 411 yards passing, 166 yards running. Pretty good job on the road.
Yeah, I think that's decent.
Yes.
First down, 10. Up the middle. It's Bo Scarborough, number 9. They will use 3 and perhaps 4. Running backs. Defensively, Vereen. There's Baylen Buchanan, who gets the start at one corner today. Second down. Stacked receivers, top of the screen. Left side. It'll be third down. Scarborough's second carry.
Watch the tape of the Arkansas game. It was Bo Scarborough's best game. He rushed for 56 yards. 40 of them were after contact. He looks to finally be loosening up and be the back that they thought he was going to be.
Third and 2. Hurts rolling out, being chased. In trouble. Terrific one-on-one. Rashawn Golden, number 7.
And Vern, that's the key, what you just said. If there was a problem against Texas A&M when you looked at that game, it was missed tackles. When you have your opportunity, you got to make the play. Left side of the screen. He makes the one-on-one tackle, something they did not do well last week against Texas A&M.
Look at the respect Alvin Kamara is giving J.K. Scott. Scott,
yes.
Kamara's all the way back at the 10. The line of scrimmage is the 34. Scott having a really, really fine year. Over a 46-yard average. Oh, my goodness. No fair catch called for. He's still loose. He is still loose. And he got some wonderful downfield blocking.
Right. I don't know if he needed it, but he got some. He is special. We talked to Nick Saban about him. He says, oh, we knew he'd be special. He's faster than everybody thinks. He breaks tackles. He's a great receiver. What a weapon.
62-yard punt. 31 on the return. It's now time to take a look at our Home Depot tools for success. Gary?
Vern, we talked about how Alabama sets the edge with their safeties as good as anyone. You must attack or be willing to attack up the middle. A good side for Tennessee is last week against Texas A&M. They did a great job of running between the tackles. Whether they used the running backs or they used Josh Dobbs, they ran it, they forced it, and they made A&M stop the inside run game. Look what they did all season, the first five games, and what they did against A&M last week. You cannot concede. As good as Alabama is on defense, stopping the run, best in the country, you can't concede the inside run game.
This is Jalen Hurd between the tackles, and he's out to the 47-yard line. Well, maybe over right tackle.
Yeah, that was inside. Listen, he had a good game a year ago in that close football game against Alabama. He had 18 rushes for 92 yards in that game. He looks fresh. He should be fresh. He took a week off, and he looks like he's ready to be the Jalen Hurd we all knew.
Three wide to the left side. Play action. Little flip out to Hurd. Nothing doing. Secure tackle from Sean Dion Hamilton, number 20.
And that's what Alabama's secondary is known for, being great tacklers. And they showed it right there. Last week, Tennessee had 391 yards passing. 314 of them came after the catch. Let's see if Alabama can tackle the catch in this game.
Alvin Kamara is now in the backfield. He comes right and is hit behind the line. Tim Williams. Well, that play didn't have any success, but what a game he had at Texas A&M last week.
Yeah. You know, Chance Hall has been a big improvement for the Tennessee offensive line, but he is struggling with Tim Williams. He's known as a pass rush specialist, but Tim Williams so far is kind of owning him in this game. Got to keep an eye on that matchup. They cannot lose that matchup, Tennessee.
Third down, 17. Wolf had moved over to the left side. Three-man rush. Dobbs pressured and dropped. Jonathan Allen. That's his fifth sack.
And Tim Williams. Two number one picks in the NFL draft. Three-man rush, and they meet at the quarterback. Both of those players could have turned pro a year ago. Both would be playing NFL football, and both will be making a lot of money after the next draft.
Player down. That's Brett Kendrick. Now, this is a Tennessee offensive line already with two subs in the starting lineup.
Yeah, he got rolled on from behind his left ankle. It might have been the opposite tackle, Chance Hall, that got him from behind.
Time called. And we'll be right back.
Hey, Evan.
Brett Kendrick getting attention on the Tennessee bench, and he is about to join a long list of those who are out. Maven, Kirkland, Sutton, Dylan Wiseman, Malik Foreman out, Cortez McDowell, Danny O'Brien, by the way, the young man who seemingly was really, really critically injured last week, actually flew back with the team after a checkup at a College Station hospital, and then on Monday was dismissed from the team for a violation of team rules. And the last guy you saw, Preston Williams, started the season as a starting receiver, and he chose to leave the team. This is Eddie Jackson at the nine. There is no flag thrown. And Jackson, now there's a flag on the far side of the field. Nothing over here. That's a 60-yard punt.
And it was a 60-yard punt outside the numbers where it was caught. It was a great punt by Trevor Daniel, who again is a big weapon for this Tennessee team.
Getting the return, blocking the back, receiving team, number 23. That's the difference from the goal. First down.
Aaron Robinson on special teams. That was a 60-yard punt. Time call.
Adam
Zucker in New York with this Ford update. NC State missed the winning field goal at the end of regulation at Clemson. And after the Tigers scored in overtime, Marcus Edmonds seals the win for number three Clemson, avoiding the upset at home as we send you back to Knoxville.
All right, Adam, thank you so much. Let's get an injury update quickly from Allie LaForce.
Vern Kendrick is dealing with a left ankle injury. He kept pointing at the top of his left ankle. They undid the tape, retaped it, and told him they're going to stick him back out there, see how it feels, and go from there.
All right. And this drive will begin at the 9-yard line. New running back in for Alabama, Damian Harris, number 34. As we mentioned, they will use three, possibly four backs on offense.
Yeah, Ardarius Stewart is back there too. Again, healthy. Lines up in the backfield.
Missed two games with a knee injury. Calvin Ridley is wide to the right. Play clock at six. Stewart in motion. Hurts. Now he'll fire it. He's got a man wide open, and Ridley lost concentration and dropped it. Oh.
Well, one of the notes I wrote on my board is don't wait around for Alabama to beat themselves. You know, I've seen them lose football games, and they usually don't do it themselves. Ole Miss got one, I remember that. But usually you have to take the game away from them. Drop pass, that does not happen very often. Especially from that guy.
Yeah, exactly. Second down, 10. Sweep, almost caught at the goal line, but he gets out of there. It's Ardarius Stewart.
One of the things that Lane Kiffin does a great job, we talked about the stats with Jalen Hurts, is controlling his passing game, what he actually is going to throw. 96 of his passes have been 10 yards or less. If you combine 10 yards or less or behind the scrimmage, he knows he's got a good defense, and he doesn't ask too much from his young quarterback.
They're down four. Tennessee blitz. Hurts rolls right, drills it, caught, first down. Ardarius Stewart just across the 20.
Speaking with Lane Kiffin, I said, well, what's he like? And he goes, he's got great composure, number one. He's got all the skills. I said, he reminds me a little bit the composure that Blake Sims has and the speed. He said, yes, but he has a bigger arm, and long-term, he has more upside, obviously. Blake was a fifth-year senior.
Here's Harris going right, getting by the first tackle. And that could be enough for the first down out near the 33. It is.
One of the challenges for Tennessee with all these injuries on defense, they're playing what they call a 4-2-5 defense. Four down linemen, two linebackers, and five defensive backs. Against Arkansas, against Kentucky, Alabama ran right at it. Ran outside zone right at that one less linebacker.
First down, 10. This is Harris. He's got a lot of room. And he spins as he crosses the 50-yard line and is tackled by Micah Abernathy.
That's the challenge. When you're losing three of your best football players, you've only got two linebackers on the field, and Alabama has the option of going right at you with the run game, and then every once in a while, you know they're going to go play action pass and go downfield.
Sweep to the right. This is Joshua Jacobs.
Same play.
And he is the third running back we've seen in the ball game. Todd Kelly Jr.
Outside zone. What's only thing different right here is that Alabama, known for running more to their left, has been running to the right in this football game, staying away from Derek Barnett.
Joshua Dobbs on my mind. It's Joshua Jacobs. And he's inside the 30. This drive began at the 9-yard line.
Where Alabama is so tough, Vern, is how good they are on first down. Against Arkansas, they had 27 first downs. They averaged 13 yards on first down against Arkansas.
Jacobs, the running back, on second down and three. Ridley, they toss it. They've got the reverse coming near side. This is our Darius Stewart, two blockers in front. He is in for the touchdown. Yes, indeed.
Darius Stewart got the last block to spring him into the end zone. What a call by Lane Kiffin. Run to the right, run to the right, run to the right. Come back with a reverse to the left.
Derek Dieter got the key block downfield, number 11.
Right there. And then Jalen Hurts gets the next one.
How often do you see a quarterback there?
I know. Darius Stewart gets the touchdown, got the quarterback and the wide receiver.
Adam Griffith for the extra point.
Got him a little mixed up there. I was doing it the opposite.
It's allowed.
Yes. Darius Stewart coming back, as Vern told you. Another weapon, as if Alabama needed one.
Sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Well, that was a brisk 91-yard drive in 8 plays. It consumed 2 minutes and 58 seconds on the clock, and Stewart got the touchdown. Short kick. Evan Berry.
He's physical.
Yes, he is. Down the sidelines, cuts inside, and is finally called down. There is a flag. It's at the 45-yard line of Tennessee.
He's physical and runs through a couple tackles and obviously has the speed to get by there. Anthony Averett, number 28, is the last guy to make the play. Had a chance, or he would have gone.
Here's Ken Williamson. Well, he's going to come over and explain this to Butch Jones. Williamson is the referee today.
Two fouls on the play. Personal foul, face mask on defense number 28. He declined. Then the corner holding number 35. 10 yards is by the foul. Tennessee ball, first down.
Okay, was I confused or are you?
I'm very confused.
I thought, was it two penalties both on Tennessee?
Pointed,
yes,
toward Alabama.
Yes, must have both been against Tennessee.
Yeah.
They took this other way. Not sure.
I thought he said holding. Oh, well, we're checking. It wiped out a 67-yard return. And it's first down at the 35-yard line. Alvin Kamara. Well, Gary mentioned that Kamara started his collegiate career at Alabama. He's out of Norcross, Georgia. Became injured just as the season started, missed the first 3 weeks. And Nick Saban told us last night it was their intention to play him, but he kind of fell behind. And at the end of the year, opted to transfer to Hutchinson Community College. He spent 1 year there.
Bottling them up now, aren't they?
Yep.
And again, you can be as strong a running back as you want to be, you got to have some help from that offensive line. And right now, that Alabama elite front seven is winning. There he is. He was up. I saw most of the time when I was watching Alabama's practice squad player, giving scout team, giving the look to the Alabama defense.
Well, physically, a big difference with him and Jalen Hurd. Hurd's at 6'4", 240. Kamara is a solid 215, very solid and quick. Here's Dobbs, pressured, caught, dropped. That's three already. Reuben Foster, who just might be an elite linebacker. Well, he is an elite linebacker.
Might be the best in the country.
Yeah,
no
that's,
doubt.
That's where I was going.
Lines back up at the second level. Looks in. And as he comes around the corner to make the play, you can see the speed to catch up to Dobbs on the play. might be Jeremy Pruitt's biggest impact on this defense. They seem to be more aggressive with man on third down. Seem to be bringing an extra linebacker and crowding those running backs. If you help, he's coming at
you. Here comes the rush. Trevor Daniel, this is low. Eddie Jackson grabs it. And he had called for the fair catch at the 24. Get the CBS Sports app for inside access to Alabama, Tennessee, or your favorite team. From signing day to game day, you'll get instant coverage of every moment from every angle. Download the CBS Sports app today. Seven nothing on this Sun Splash Saturday in Knoxville, Tennessee, the 99th meeting. Alabama, by the way, has won 18 games in a row, and they have defeated Tennessee each of the last nine encounters.
Remember the last time Alabama had the ball. They were running the outside zone to the right. They were running away from Derek Barnett, and then they ran the reverse to get the big play.
Joshua Jacobs is the running back. Hurts. Yes.
A lot went wrong there. I think Trayvon Diggs, number seven, corner blitz. It actually was a zone that time. Diggs might not be all that wrong that time. They were playing zone and bringing the corner. Bobby Shoup is giving Alabama everything he has early in the game. You don't want to go down again. Not against Alabama.
Second down and 10 from the 25. Dylan Bates, number 17, was closest to that ball a moment ago. Blitz, Hurts as he gets hit, and that forces the incomplete pass. Colton Jumper, he's on in place of the injured Darren Kirkland, and Jumper has been a factor since he got into that starting lineup.
There was. They showed the blitz from Jalen Hurts left, and then they brought it from the field side to get third and long. Now, we saw Tim Williams and Jonathan Allen make an impact. Can Derek Barnett and Corey Vereen do the same thing? Remember, we talked in the open. Can they find stars to help? They got him in a tackle position right there.
Hurts chased. Incomplete.
And it was Corey Vereen, I think, that put the pressure on him.
Yep.
Just inside. Oh, no, actually it was not. It was actually number 40 that made
the
play.
Instead of 50, yes. Demaria Mixon. Yes. Yes.
You know why Vereen mixed it up? By putting his hand up like he did something.
Fourth down. J.K. Scott at a 62-yarder last time out. Kamara's back at the 20. And the return is on all the way for Tennessee. Kamara at the 16. Watch out.
Oh, that's going to be 15.
He was out of bounds.
Oh, my goodness. They got it. Yeah, they're going to get 15.
It took a little while, yeah.
Yes. Sometimes when it happens on the friendly bench, it doesn't get called, but that was an obvious one.
Keith Holcomb, number 42.
And I'll tell you what, Kamara is limping on the play. That would be a tough guy to lose. He gets a real late hit, and it looks like his right ankle or knee is
after
bothering
the player's
him.
Over. Personal foul. Kicking team. 15 yards.
Got him on the hip, didn't he?
Yeah. So the 15 has been marked off against Holcomb and the Crimson Tide. And that gives Tennessee the ball at the 40-yard line with a minute to go in the first quarter of play.
And Vern, Brent Kendrick has not come in. Drew Richmond, number 51, is playing left tackle.
So that's three subs in the offensive line for Tennessee. Blitz, Dobbs, incomplete.
Right, a lot of the fans want to know, 50-50 ball. with Juwan Jennings to the outside going against Anthony Averett. Did he grab him? It's just fighting right there. They're going to let that one go. Oh, he had him by the jersey. The back official did not see it. He was screened on that play. That could have been called.
And instead it goes as an incompletion. Nothing doing on second down. Jalen Hurd.
One more look to see how the back judge, side judge was for. See, he cannot see it. It was grabbed. He had jersey, and Juwan Jennings and the 100,000 fans were correct. That could have and should have been called.
Field judge Glenn Fusick did not make the call. On third down, Hurd alongside Dobbs in the backfield. It's 7-0. Screen pass. Intercepted. And here goes Alabama. Ronnie Harrison. Touchdown. That is the 10th non-offensive touchdown of the year for Alabama. 58 yards.
I was pretty sure Tennessee's defense couldn't shut out Alabama's offense. I think their hope was Tennessee's offense could shut out Alabama's defense.
Answer?
And that hasn't happened.
No.
That's 9 games in a row they've had a non-offensive touchdown.
Adam Griffith for the extra point.
It was supposed to be a safe screen pass. They grabbed the ball player. He's standing right here. Let's see what happens. Going to bring the player in motion. That's who the screen is going to go to, I believe. Yes, they grab him. When he throws the ball, it goes right over his head.
Harrison with the interception, 58 yards. It was Ryan Anderson with the pressure on Joshua Dobbs.
An inside play, the grabbing of the running back is really what allowed the ball to sail over the running back's hands and get the interception.
Now, how about that? A missed interference call inside the 20-yard line. And then the interception returned for a touchdown by Alabama. Happens quickly, doesn't it? Nothing with 14 seconds to go, first quarter.
Go paperless, don't stress, girl.
Matt LeBlanc returns to television as the man with the plan. Don't miss the new comedy premiering Monday, October 24th, right here on CBS. 14-0. Ninth straight game with a non-offensive touchdown. How about that? The longest streak by any team.
Remember in Michigan State game, Cyrus Jones had a touchdown on punt return, and then in the national championship, Kenyon Drake, kickoff return for a touchdown. So that adds it up to last year.
Adam Griffith will kick off. Evan Berry had a 67-yard return, wiped out by a penalty a moment ago, and this will be a touchback.
We talked about Jeremy Pruitt and how they use their linebackers. Reuben Foster has the blitz and the running back. Watch him engage the center as he's coming and go for the running back. He grabs Jalen Hurd just enough to cause the interception and the easy pick six. Now, Tennessee fans are saying, okay, we've been here before.
Yes.
But you're going to do it, as you look at Jeremy Pruitt, you're going to go to a Nick Saban team, it's going to be tough. 14-0, Nick Saban, 96-3 with a 14-point lead. Vern, we did two of those three losses when he had 14-point leads.
Okay. Hey, this is the Aflac trivia question.
You were out at dinner.
Yeah. And you... And you wonder how Gary spends Friday nights. It's coming up with stuff like this.
All right.
Okay.
2010, Cam Newton. Remember the comeback?
Oh, of course, yeah. Yeah.
2013, the kick six.
Remember them both. Now I do.
And then the Ohio State game in the semifinal. Three losses.
End of one. 14-0. We might have a special guest coming. We'll find out after the commercial break. We welcome all of you back to Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. 14-0 as Alabama erupted. And take a look at the point differential for Tennessee this year.
They've done it before.
Yeah.
Only problem is 19 plays so far for Tennessee, 7 negative plays already.
3 traps already, 3 sacks, that is. There's Hurd around the corner.
Hard to get outside. Reuben Foster, he was the guy that made the play. Sideline to sideline.
Christian Miller and Reuben Foster.
Took him a couple years to get out there, but just the latest in the great middle linebackers, Reggie Ragland, C.J. Mosley, Rolando McClain, just the long line of middle linebackers for Alabama.
They're down 5. Alvin Kamara. Good to see him back on the field after that return, which he was thumped pretty badly. Here's Dobbs. Nope.
Yep, they're playing the sticks right now. Alabama, they know the pass rush is going to get there. They're playing 3rd and 6. You're going to have to try to go deep. Problem is, don't have the time. Easy to play DB when you know you're going to get that pass rush. Like that Super Bowl game we watched with Denver. Got to cover him for about a second and a half.
That brings on Trevor Daniel again. Eddie Jackson deep. He waits at the 25-yard line. 14-0.
Look at this punting. He is.
Well, both of them have excelled, haven't they? Here's Jackson at the 10. And he's brought down at the 22-yard line. 14-0. Alabama leads it. We're in the first minute of the second quarter. 60-yard punt. 12 on the return. Will be right back. Alabama leading Tennessee. It's with real pleasure that we welcome back one of the revered figures in athletics at Tennessee, Peyton Manning, who wore number 16 here, number 18 in the NFL. You have maintained a very close relationship with your alma mater.
Well, I sure have, Vern. It's been a very special place to me. Started back in 1994, and in many ways I've never left this place. And always been special to come back here, usually on one bye week a year. This is my third game this season, and just proud to be just an ambassador for this great university.
I'm not sure where Gary. Oh, there's Gary. Look at this.
Kind of assumed you'd be wearing the robe.
Where's Lionel Richie? Is he behind you? Is he behind you?
Sorry, I just assumed.
I would have worn mine if I would have known.
I would have been out of here if both of you showed up in robes.
I want some football?
Sure.
Let's do some football.
Okay. This is good. Good stuff.
That's a good gotcha. Deep right side. Oh, is he ever. That's Calvin Ridley. Well, you have had 3 games here this year, and they've been coming from behind all along.
By the way,
yeah,
it's pretty comfortable. By the way,
is it? It looks on you. It looks good.
He may never give it back. You realize that?
We're at the Tuscaloosa next week.
Try that. Yeah.
It's as you guys know, Tennessee games don't start until the second half. So this is just kind of pregame warm-ups here. We're just kind of toying with them, and we're going to get things going here in the second half. But we certainly got our work cut out for us.
Well, we said when they were down 21 a week or two ago with it, they've got them right where they want
them. That's right. That's right. I told Butch Jones, I said, your job is to convince them that they're down 21-0 in pregame warm-ups.
There was a petition to start the scoreboard at 21-0.
I was in favor of it.
Second down and 8. And nothing doing this time as they got to Joshua Jacobs.
Peyton, as you watch football and you watch Tennessee and you watch those exciting football games, What do you miss more, the exhilaration or the intensity of preparing for a game, getting ready for a game?
Well, you miss all of it, but obviously you guys have caught some great games this year. In the Tennessee-Georgia game a few weeks ago was special. I was in College Station. There's nothing quite like SEC football, Gary, and this season's been really special. So you miss the atmosphere, but it's great to come back and just be a fan of these games.
Third down. The need is 8. Calvin Ridley, now Ardarius Stewart in motion. They flip it out to Stewart.
Good defense.
Sure was. It'll be fourth down. Elliott Berry led the way.
Well, that's what you have to do. We talked all about this. Your back seven, your linebackers have to eat up space. Modern football, a lot of short passes. You've got to come up and hold those yards after catch.
Now here's J.K. Scott as Butch Jones congratulates his defenders. And Alvin Kamara is deep at the 10-yard line again, showing the respect they have for J.K. Scott. Young man out of Denver, Colorado. Nice and high again. They'll let this one bounce, and it goes out of bounds. Not as effective as they had hoped. It's out of bounds at the 24.
Peyton, you had a lot of thrills. The band, meeting your teammates. Would you like to play quarterback when we come back for Tennessee? Why don't we pick your brain on what you see when we come back?
Sure. I'm out of eligibility playing-wise, but I'll give you what I can see. What I see.
In a robe.
Don't miss the premiere of The Great Indoors with Joel McHale. CBS October 27th.
Pre-game, Peyton Manning, number 16 here at Tennessee, introduced. Philip Fulmer, his coach. Kids, that was the ovation was thunderous.
Well, this is a special place and great fans here. And like I said earlier, these fans have supported me in NFL stadiums all across the country for the past 18 years. And we had a great reunion last night, a bunch of players that played during my time here. And nothing quite like the relationships you form with the fans, your teammates, coaches here in college.
Peyton, you've earned the right to do about what you want to do now. What do you think's in your future? Before you answer that, my job's a terrible job. You would not want my job.
I wouldn't?
No,
oh,
this
no,
is not,
it's pretty.
You do not want
it's
this.
It's good
job
up here. You get to wear a robe to work.
Because if you want it, you know you're going to get it. You know that, don't you?
Get to come to Knoxville every other Saturday.
Don't, this is a bad job. This is not a good job.
Not a bad gig.
I remember when we had this chat when you had sat out the year. And at the end of the quarter, Gary said to you,
don't do it.
Peyton, I hope you play for another 10
That's
years.
Right.
Well, I knew it was the right year to go out in style. I knew if Vern Lundquist was retiring from football, it was
right.
Time for me to retire from football. Right? All the legends are stopping football, and it just seemed like the right time for me. But it's just been fun watching a lot of football this year, Gary. I watch you guys every Saturday. Obviously keep up with the NFL, but it's kind of been fun being a fan this fall.
When do you think you will make a decision about what you want to do?
Yeah, it's hard to say. I kind of think the answer, I hope, will kind of come to me. And I think this fall you kind of find out what you miss, what you don't miss. And I think the timing and the answer will just kind of come to me. But it really has been an enjoyable fall so
Peyton,
far.
Hey, don't you just have to find something that captures your intensity that you took to football for 19 years? Isn't that what you're looking for?
Well, certainly. I mean, obviously, football has provided quite the consistent routine for the past 22 years. And so you like to find something that kind of gives you somewhat that same schedule. So we'll see. We'll see.
Well, that was intended for Juwan Jennings. It was incomplete.
Yeah, I thought Tennessee might need these 50-50 balls. You know you're going to get bump and run. You got to challenge the bump and run, don't you, Pete?
That's our best chance right now with the injuries up front. I'd like to maybe get a pass interference call or get something to shorten these drives.
Peyton, you know how brave we are, Vern and I, putting you on a game with Alabama. There's about 6 people in Alabama that still like us. 2 of them are relatives. After this, there's not going to be any more. You do know that.
Hopefully they'll forgive you.
That's right.
Wearing the robe, maybe that gives you a little star.
Here's the challenge. If he wears the robe in Tuscaloosa.
That's right.
No.
Well, now
next
we'll
week.
Find out.
Yeah. See how tough I am.
I want to see you interview Nick Saban wearing that robe. That will be a first, Vern. And even in all years of TV, you'll never seen something like that.
I will send you photos of that if it occurs.
Please do.
Stick
please
with
do.
Us.
Okay.
Just a second. Well, you faced this Alabama team four times. I think the 95 game was among your favorites, right? It snapped the loop.
Sure did. It was a great game. They've beaten us quite a few years in a row, and that play right there, we fumbled a few years in the past on the goal lines, and we decided just to keep it on a blind bootleg and got in the end zone, and great memories down there in Legion Field, that's for sure.
You know, Peyton, you and Eli got a lot of Arch's records in the NFL. You know, I played against Arch. I'll tell you what, if you and Eli can have the same record as your pop and Olivia, your mom, raising your families, that might be the best part of your career.
No doubt about it. Been really lucky having two great parents, and they've supported all of us, me, Cooper, and Eli, and all of our endeavors, and just really appreciative and really thankful, really grateful. Thank you, Gary.
First down 10. Alabama has Damian Harris in. Blitz. Oh, they didn't get to it. Hurts incomplete.
Tried to get that to the tight end, O.J. Howard. O.J. Howard, the hero of the national championship game, has only been targeted 18 times this year. Tough to get it to their tight ends with a young freshman quarterback. It's a risky throw. Peyton can do it, right, Peyton? But there's high risk, high reward with the tight end.
I agree. You know, a lot of times, but those throws on the outside, right, outside the hash marks are safer, right? There's not much of a chance of a tip ball, and those are going more to the wide outs.
Second down 10. Alabama up 14-0. Calvin Ridley in motion. Fake to him. Hurts steps up, goes deep. Almost intercepted.
So it's your team. You've been watching them a lot as we watch this underthrow right here. You know, even this game, if they happen to lose this game, they're still alive, might get some guys healthy. What do you think about your football team?
There's no question. These games are relevant again, right? Yes. Tennessee, Alabama always used to be a relevant game. It's relevant again. It hasn't been maybe in years past. And so that's where we are. That's where Butch Jones has brought us back. And like you said, we love to win this game, but if for some reason it doesn't happen, we have every chance to be in Atlanta, right. And that's the goal. And when you get to Atlanta, anything can happen. So Butch has done a heck of a job, and we're really lucky to have him. He's brought Tennessee back to where we used to be, to where Johnny Majors and Philip Fulmer had it, and it's really exciting to be part of the Tennessee football program again.
Yeah, the matchup we were going to look at and be interested in, Cam Robinson.
Start, offense number 74.
That was Cam Robinson.
Remains third down.
Left tackle Cam Robinson has Derek Barnett, the elite pass rusher for Tennessee, and you can assume that he's going to try to cheat that snap anytime he can with that guy to the outside. Peyton, I didn't know if I was going to do this, but as you leave, I just wanted to say, so great to have you in our booth.
I'm telling you, all kind of plugs up here we get.
No, right? You know, I've got to get you,
DirecTV,
Gary Danielson,
nationwide,
yeah.
Fired up for this, right?
I got to get you out to dinner.
Here we go.
Fumbled.
Got it, baby.
Wow.
There you go. Forced turnover.
Derek Barnett.
We talked about the matchup and why they had to get off the line. And what does he do? Come around the outside. Cam tried to hold him, sacks him, and punches it loose.
Huge play. We got to get a touchdown. Tennessee's got to get a touchdown and build off this momentum. Great play. He's been a stud all year. He's been awesome for us.
And I think DeMario Mixon, number 40, is the guy who was the recipient of the fumble this time. So but you can't leave now, Peyton. You just got a lucky turnover.
That's right. That's exactly right. I don't miss those hits there, Gary. I do not miss those.
Let's see what they do down here. Do they run the quarterback? That's when the offense for Tennessee has worked the best.
I want to score on first or second down. I want to stay out of third down versus these guys.
Well, it's going to be second down. That's Kamara. Jonathan Allen defensively. 10 minutes to go, first half.
What would you be thinking, Peyton, if you had a mismatch of an offensive lineman? How do you try to combat that as a quarterback?
Like I said, three-step drop, quick phase, shotgun, get it out of your hand. These first and second down sacks have been killing us prior to. So get in there.
He got it.
Can you say that? Can
nice
I do that?
Call. Of course you can.
All right, good. Sorry.
Of course you can. Alvin Kamara.
I like it. Second down, right, Gary?
You got it.
Don't even get in the third down.
That's the
Don't
hard
get
part.
In the third down. they're too good at stopping you on third down. So that's what I usually talk about. Let's go first down, second down, first down.
Right. Avoid the third down play. Kamara is such an excellent running back.
We got a ball game now.
Aaron Medley for the extra point. Parker Henry will hold. Kamara's touchdown has cut the lead in half after Hurts fumble when hit by Derek Barnett. Let's take a look at the fumble again.
Well, coming around the blind side, Hurts feels him but does not understand how quick he could close it. Tennessee had gained 11 yards prior to that turnover, and then they gain 11 yards for the touchdown.
As Peyton just said, we've got a ball game now.
Thanks for coming in, guys. Thank you so much.
I've got Gary and Eli penciled in for Tuesday.
I'm available. Brit nachos.
Big win for Vandy. Zach Cunningham on 4th-and-1 with a minute to go brings down Isaiah McKenzie. And Derek Mason gets his first road win in SEC play. Back to Knoxville.
All right, Adam, thank you. Alvin Kamara after the fumble forced by Derek Barnett. And we're hearing Rocky Top. First composed by Felice and Blue Drill Bryant. I knew I was going to get that in.
Got it. But when we talk about also, Vern, the stars for Tennessee.
Yeah.
Got all those great players out for Tennessee. That means their stars have to lead the way. And Barnett made the biggest play for Tennessee in the game so far. Oh, that's going to be a penalty.
Yep. Out of bounds.
The official is straddling the pylon. If it goes to his right, he knows.
Receivers have elected to put the ball in play at the 35-yard line. First down.
Aaron Medley. Quick and Loans presents today's scholar athletes for Alabama, Minka Fitzpatrick, and Joshua Dobbs for Tennessee. Quicken Loans commitment to the investment of our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to Alabama and Tennessee's General Scholarship Fund.
Well, we're going to see what kind of patience that Lane Kiffin has. They've had success running the outside zone to the right. Do they start running again? Yes, they do.
And they come to the right. Damian Harris is caught at the 48-yard line.
How disciplined can Lane Kiffin be? Remember, he was the coach of this Tennessee team. He wants to show him what a great play caller he is. Will he have the patience to stick and grind it out?
They come right. It's Damian Harris again across midfield and down at the 48. Minutes to go, first half, 14-7. Harris again, and this time nothing there. Elliot Berry, number 41. He and Joe Evan Berry, so much a part of this defensive unit, and now here comes the crowd.
How about that tackle by Berry? He's really a number 3 linebacker in there. Kirkland and Jalen Reeves-Maben are their starters. They got their backups in. They've lost McDowell, and in comes Berry. Wow, what a play.
3rd-and-7. Ardarius Stewart across the backfield gets a little swing pass and gets a terrific block from Calvin Ridley. Oh, boy. A wide receiver highlight.
Remember we talked about the passing patience that Lane Kiffin gives his quarterback. Even though it's 3rd-and-long, he still throws the ball behind the line of scrimmage. 96 passes behind the line of scrimmage or less than 10 yards downfield.
Quick screen. How about that defense? Emmanuel Mosley read that from the snap.
just get the feeling with this Tennessee. I don't know if they can match up talent-wise. Peyton said they've come a long way, but they have 7 of their 18 returning starters not playing in this football game. They had 18 returning starters for 2016, and 7 of them are injured.
Hurts gets a good block. He's into the secondary. Foot race at the 10. Touchdown, Alabama. Miller Forrestall, number 87, was the man who supplied the block. Now that has quieted the crowd.
Well, we've talked about Alabama for a long time, Vernon. One of the things that's really underrated about this football team, and it's been for as long as I can remember, of how clutch of a football team they are. They make plays in the clutch. People make runs at them. Remember the onside kick against Clemson? They've done it time after time. They just seem to be able to answer the bell. Really crafty play here. They sneak the tight end instead of a pass this way. It's actually a run. They get the lead blocker downfield. Ardarius Stewart gets a good block, number 13. 2 blocks, and that running quarterback. Alabama with a running quarterback, it almost doesn't seem fair, does it?
You're right. Jalen Hurts with the touchdown. 21-7. 21-7 after that 45-yard run from Hurts.
With backups in the game, oftentimes misalignments happen. I'm pretty sure Tennessee misaligned on this play and helped make a play that should have gained 5 or 6 yards into a big touchdown play. We'll show you.
Adam Griffith will kick off. And it's Barry again, the deep man, with Micah Abernathy. But here is the kick, and Griffith sails it through the end zone.
Watch, Tennessee has backups. Colton Jumper is going to tell the other linebacker right here to move over. Now watch what happens. When Alabama shifts, both linebackers to the left. Alabama gets exactly what they want. Both linebackers are caught up in the trash. I think it was a misalignment and a mistake by the Tennessee defense playing with a lot of subs.
Now the Volunteers trailing again by 14. And they've got the ball at the 25. Caden Hurd. That's Hurd's 7th carry for 29 yards. Kamara has carried it 6 times, but he has been held in check.
I'll tell you who else has been held in check. Last year, Dobbs rushed 16 times for 19 yards. He's off to even worse start this game.
Hurd goes right. It's going to be 3rd down.
Yes, sack yards are included, but 19 yards, there were 38 yards in sacks last year, and already in this game, the sacks are mounting up. But Tennessee does not seem to be able to spring their quarterback in the running game, and that's a big part of their run game.
3rd down. They need 6 to sustain the drive. Jalen Hurd is the running back.
Well, Alabama attack again. They've been doing it every time in 3rd down. Looks like they will.
Delayed blitz, Dobbs. Ah, nice catch.
It's really close, though.
Yep,
Jawan Jennings. He got it, I think. Got over the line. Listen, I said this a week ago, but people might not have heard it. I think the people that, for this football team, that provides the energy are the receivers for Tennessee, especially number 15.
First down 10, that's Ethan Wolf, number 82 in motion. Here comes the run blitz.
He might have misread that one, Josh Dobbs. Could have kept that one and had some positive yards.
Some murmuring among the Tennessee crowd.
Watch it get closed down. Could have kept it to the right. Thought he had a play to get positive yards and break out. Problem is, Alabama's been giving up yards, but it's been mostly in the pass. Ole Miss and Arkansas combined for 821 pass yards. Can Tennessee find some passing yards?
Dobbs. Not that one.
Butch Jones is working the referees for the next call right now. He knows, obviously, he's not going to get that one. Was there a tug on the play? Not enough. Marlon Humphrey had a little bit of a rough night against Arkansas, giving up a touchdown, a pass interference, but Marlon Humphrey's played a lot of football for Alabama.
That was Brandon Johnson, the intended receiver.
Let's see if Tennessee has to keep in help on this third and long.
Three down.
They don't.
No. Dobbs near side. Kamara, but it's way short.
Yeah, but you could see Dobbs had that clock going off in his head. I mean, third and 10, he threw to his first receiver 2 yards downfield. That's what a pass rush. See, a pass rush there does not show up in the stats, but effectively that was pass rush early in the game that say really got the stop on third and long.
Anthony Averett with the tackle, and that brings on Trevor Daniel. And this is already going to be his sixth punt of the first half. Eddie Jackson is deep.
Outside the numbers again.
Jackson will run it back. Nice tackle. At the 23-yard line, Evan Berry not only returns it, he defends it. 49-yard punt. The Geico halftime report coming up. See if Rick Neuheisel, Brian Jones, Adam Zucker have donned robes for the halftime report.
Well, you know, every series is crucial.
Right.
But right now, with 4:40 to go, the Tennessee defense, if they give up a drive in points, Alabama's going to get it again at the start of the second half. Probably the most crucial part of the game if Tennessee wants to mount another comeback in this football game.
4:40 to go, 21-7. Damian Harris, the running back. And he runs into orange traffic at the 22, Shy Tuttle, first one there. Tennessee has two timeouts remaining. Butch Jones in his fourth year as the head coach at Tennessee. Corner blitz. Whoa, boom. Hurts still has it.
The added dimension, you know, Blake Sims gave it to him a little bit that 1 year that they played, but you can see the offense is now expanded. They're not just the same pounding ground team. They still do that effectively when they need to or have to, but now they've added another dimension. They probably don't have as intricate pass offense as the pass. It's just a different pass offense, more deep balls.
There's the quarterback rushing list, and Hurts lining up that list. Blake Sims is the current leader. First down on the last play. Hurts gets a good block from Harris, then delivers it out to Ridley, who could not hang on to it. Second drop for Ridley. Well, this make or break stretch for the Volunteers. They trailed 21-0 in the first half here, won it against Florida. Amazing finish to the Georgia game last week. Lost in double overtime, and they trail Alabama. So they have trailed by double digits in every game this year, save one. That was a victory over Ohio University. Hurts.
Same play as the touchdown.
Yep, gets a ball. What a block he got downfield. This time there is a defender with an angle, but holy cow.
I think it was O.J. Howard this time that got the block. He was the player that lined up left, came across, and then gets the block. Linebacker this time is in the right spot. Let's see if it makes any difference. No, it did not. He went with the flow. Again, our Darius Stewart gets the block, and then O.J. Howard throws downfield, and You got a 4.65 quarterback. There's O.J. Howard, and there's your quarterback getting around the end.
Harris caught for a loss. Derek Barnett again.
Yeah, Corey Vereen, number 50 that time, beat O.J. Howard on the edge, set the edge and forced it back, and got the negative play for the Tennessee defense.
Second and 13, 3:20 to go. Stewart comes near side.
Calvin Ridley been very, very quiet. If I'm Tennessee, I don't lose where he is.
And playing way off of him. Hurts. Toss. Harris cut back. Double teamed and down at the 22-yard line. That'll be just short of the first down. Alabama with all three timeouts left. Third and one. Joshua Jacobs is the running back on this third down play. He gets it and moves to the 20. That will move the chain for Alabama.
We've seen it firsthand. We've been here for most of it. A little different challenge they've got here with Alabama.
Jacobs still in the backfield. Bradley Bozeman, the center, looks around to make sure he's got the snap count here. Two men to the left, two to the right. Jalen Hurts, left side, safety valve. It's Jacobs. That is some safety valve. Cut down at the 12-yard line.
One of the great things that Jalen Hurts did on this one was climb up into the pocket. Instead of trying to get behind Barnett, and he knows he's got Cam Robinson, easy to get inside. Cam Robinson, if they did ever huddle again, would have said thanks. Thanks for going up in the pocket.
Second down.
have to tell him tomorrow, I think, nowadays. Uh-oh, oh, stumbled.
Yes, he did. And that was banged in the air. Shy Tuttle tipped it. How significant is that if
it's
you're
huge.
A volunteer?
It's huge, and I do think Jalen Hurts was just trying to throw it away. He becomes discombobulated. He wants to fake the pitch. It is a pass play. Now he's just trying to throw it away. Great play by Shy Tuttle, and it's a good thing Hurts made the tackle, or we would have had a knot for Tennessee. Plenty of time in the half now.
Two timeouts left.
I think there were maybe 10 people in this stadium that didn't think Alabama was going to score on that drive.
Right.
And now it's turned the other way around.
From the 32, Dobbs. Little safety valve, check down. Jalen Hurd. Ronnie Harrison made the tackle. Harrison in this game has a 58-yard interception return for a touchdown. Second down, and the Volunteers will hustle.
Just remember the right side of this Tennessee line, two true sophomores, Chance Hall and Jack Jones, both started a year ago for Tennessee as true freshmen in Tuscaloosa in that close football game.
Play clock is at six.
Wouldn't be the worst thing to take a timeout here and make sure you have the right play going.
Yep, they did. Time called with 1:17 to go before the break. 21-7, Alabama. October 27th, only CBS.
Just to give you an idea of how good this Alabama defense is, remember Tennessee put up 684 yards last week. In this game, 33 plays for 41 yards so far in the game.
Dobbs across the middle. Incomplete, intended for Jawan Jennings. And again, Joshua Dobbs popped as he lets it go.
against Texas A&M. Josh Dobbs is not a great intermediate passer. Against A&M, he was 2 for 14 on passes thrown more than 10 yards downfield. Just not his game. Play action passes, yet. Pocket passes, tough for him.
Snap on third down. Dobbs across the middle. Almost intercepted. Dobbs down on the ground again. Ryan Anderson, Jonathan Allen had a meeting at Joshua Dobbs.
Just look at the electric speed coming off the edge in the pass rush here on Dobbs. He can feel this. Number 22 that time, Ryan Anderson, is just, he can feel him. After a while, you know, backside, it hurts. Front side intimidates you because you can see it coming.
And so Trevor Daniel will punt for the seventh time in the first half. This is high and deep and taken on the fair catch from Eddie Jackson. Well, what kind of day has Tim Williams had so far?
Well, I will say this about this Alabama defense. Tim Williams is one of the elite pass rushers in all of college football. The SEC has probably 7 or 8 top pass rushers. 3 of them play for Alabama. Tim Williams, who you're watching, Ryan Anderson, who we just had the last highlight of, and Jonathan Allen, number 93. And you have 3 of the top 7 pass rushers for you, chances are you got a pretty good pass rush.
First down 10 now, Alabama with a 14-point lead and 62 seconds to go in the first half. Damian Harris gets around the edge. Well, Gary, you mentioned some of the defensive ends. Let's take a look at your list.
Well, I mean, just some of them. I mean, Arden Key from LSU. We'll see him in a few weeks against this Alabama team. Carl Lawson is, when healthy, one of the best in college football. Charles Harris. A lot of people don't know about him. The NFL does.
Damian Harris with the carry.
I'll tell you, one more first down for Alabama, and we might see something going deep here. Maybe a deep 50-50 ball to Calvin Ridley. Throw something deep. If a mistake happens, they live with it downfield. I'd look for a deep throw here pretty soon.
4 wides. Hurts. That was intended for Garrett Dieter.
Yeah, I thought it was Dieter. Tennessee took a timeout there. I wonder if they had the wrong group of people out there, or maybe not enough players out there.
It's a full house here at Neyland Stadium. The current capacity, 102,000. Stadium is 95 years old. There were 17 rows of seats on the west side back in 1921 when the Tennessee team defeated Emory and Henry 27-0.
Just we had to get out of that package. We did not forget about Myles Garrett being one of the great defensive ends.
Right.
We remember Deshaun Hall, his partner over there, ain't bad either.
No,
we'll,
not at
we'll
all.
See them next week. But Tim Williams right there is a beast in pass rush.
First down 10. That last play did not count. Time was taken just before the snap.
I think it was a misalignment again. I'm sure Bob Shoup up in the box, the defensive coordinator, didn't like it, didn't want to give up a big play, and called timeout.
Empty backfield. 3 to the right. Now they're going to meet 4.
Quarterback's wrong.
Yeah, design play. And that is going to be well short of the first down. LaTroy Lewis, number 4.
Alabama will take a timeout now.
So they have 2 remaining, and they have a 14-point lead. 21-7, and we invite you to join We Need to Talk, 8 o'clock Tuesday night. CBS Sports Network. Allie LaForce, a regular on that program, but Allie gets a week off.
She should be following the Cubs. What do you mean?
I think she probably is.
Husband there?
Yeah. Joe Smith. Up the middle. Joshua Jacobs. Now what? 14 seconds to go.
Either ground the ball really quickly and spike it or use a timeout. Alabama took a timeout. Open field that tackle that time. Alabama has been conservative just enough, but the running game has got them into position to throw one wherever they want and try a field goal, at least.
If it is incomplete, I'm just saying, Adam Griffith, he tried one from 57, I remember.
This would be about right.
Yeah.
I think that's what Nick said in the huddle right there. You can do anything you want except kick a field goal with 1 second to go.
Well, as you know, I think the Florida LSU game has been rescheduled. It will be played in Baton Rouge. Some controversy about that.
Yeah, but I think the commissioner finally got everybody to get on the same page. Florida gave up a home game. They're going to get a return home game next year from LSU. And all things considered, where they were a week ago, much better this week.
Yeah. 21-7, Calvin Ridley, top of the screen. There are three wides to the right. Now O.J. Howard will line up just off his right tackle. And they throw it. Nice play. Calvin Ridley.
I was wondering when Alabama would ever win one of those RPOs where everybody else has been doing it against them. That's exactly what they did. Their linemen were downfield. There was only 3 yards. I think Alabama wanted to say, you know what? We've had two of these score against us. Let's see if we can score one of those against someone else.
9 seconds to go. They do have one timeout left.
Oh, he could.
Hurts has it.
I thought it would be close the way as far as he ran it like that.
Yep.
He could run out the half.
I think the half has ended.
Nick was signaling timeout, but the play was not over. It was too wide of a play. Now, nope, the official is going to give Alabama 1 second on the clock.
Oh, no.
Fake to the left side. Hurts is carrying it. 4-3. Player is down. That's a good call. That's a good call. Clock ran out another second. Alabama will get a try for an extra field goal. One play. We talked about it, but I mean, you just got to play it the way it is. You got to go field goal here. And Butch is arguing, but he's going to lose this one.
Here is Adam Griffith, born in Poland, adopted by a couple that lives in Calhoun, Georgia.
This is a tough drive for Tennessee, Vern. Six plays. They went 54 yards, five of them on the ground to get into field goal range.
One more. Watch the clock. He's down.
And on the wide side of the field, Nick Saban is calling timeout to the official nearest him. He was right next to the referee the whole time.
Cole Mazza is the snapper. Bateman will hold it. Adam Griffith.
And Butch can't freeze him like last week.
Up.
Missed it.
Sure did.
On the other hand, it was just no points. And what didn't go the other way? It's a win for Alabama on 1 second field goals.
Wide right. And we've reached the half. Now it's time for Inside Access presented by AT&T, official sponsor of the SEC. Here's Allie with Nick Saban.
Coach, after both of Jalen.
Aaron Medley will kick for the Volunteers. Decides to run it out. And he gets it out to the 25. It's Barry. Well, we're back here, and I've got a guy sitting to my left who doesn't have a bathrobe on now. It's an unaccustomed position for you. That worked well, by the way.
That was fun. You know, you can see with a fan and Peyton. You know, get in there. That's what all the people that watch these games. But here it is. You start to think, could this be like Florida? Has that feel? You know, 21-3, 21-7. But only 41 yards in offense. They had 162 against Florida. Tennessee, as much as they need stops, can they find some offense against this great Alabama defense? That's really, you know, when Butch says, can we get into the fourth quarter? How does he do that without finding some more offense?
First down, 10. Oh. Might have illegal motion here. Let's take a look at first half trends.
Well, as you can look at the quarterbacks here, the passing game, Jalen Hurts and both Josh Dobbs, neither of them have been very effective throwing the football. Both under a lot of pressure when they try to throw this ball, especially Josh Dobbs. There's the total yards again. But the real key, remember, Tennessee held Alabama a year ago with a Heisman Trophy running back, Derrick Henry, to 117 rush yards. In the first half, Alabama rushed for 245 yards.
Many of those from this man, the freshman quarterback, Jalen Hurts, who on first down, I believe, has enough to move the chain. Yes, he does.
Yeah, he's gone over 100 yards rushing. But, you know, right behind him, Damian Harris has got it. I mean, they've got their running backs the last three games as a group have been averaging 8 yards per carry.
Damian Harris goes to the right this time on first down. Emmanuel Mosley, number 12, gets him. Harris, a sophomore from Richmond, Kentucky. He'll give way now to Joshua Jacobs. We saw Bo Scarborough to begin the game. He carried twice, and we've not seen him back at all since then. Hurts will throw. Oh boy, mix up there as Gary Dieter expected.
Well, we talked about how both offensive coordinators, Mike DeBoard and Lane Kiffin, are managing their quarterbacks. Look at nothing deep, nothing in the middle. If they're going to do anything, they're going to make mistakes. They want to throw it to the sideline or short.
Bo Scarborough is now on the field.
And again, stars. Here's a star matchup here. Derek Barnett right there. He moved just as I was going to do it.
Calvin Ridley, bottom of the screen. It's third down and 7. Timeout. Crimson Tide.
Prior to the expiration of the play clock, timeout, Alabama. First time out of the half.
Less than a minute played in the third quarter of play. 21-7 timeout, Alabama.
Your can't stink in playoffs.
Aerial coverage today is provided by Goodyear. For 60 years, Goodyear has provided aerial coverage of college football's greatest traditions and biggest rivalries. More than 102,000 gathered here in Neyland on the banks of the Tennessee River. Notice that. Tyler Watts in 2001 had 2 100-yard rush games. Hurts, 9 carries, 108 yards. 21-7, third down and 7. Ardarius Stewart in backfield.
Derek Barnett's going to get, or the offensive line is going to get called. Barnett flinched into the neutral zone. I'm not sure if Alabama moved.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, 88. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
O.J. Howard.
I think he was a little bit outside of the picture on the bottom right here. Whoa, I'm not sure who caused who to flinch there, to tell you the truth. Surely Derek Barnett did not see that, did he?
No.
He was looking inside. It's almost as if the defensive player forced O.J. Howard to move in the slot.
Third and 12. Blitz. Little pass into the flat. Nothing there. Damian Harris pursued and brought down by Elliot Berry.
It's as if Bob Shoup, defensive coordinator for Tennessee, figured out in long yardage there was no way Lane Kiffin and Nick Saban were going to allow their quarterback to turn the ball over. They were playing screen all the way. Berry never took one step back.
And that brings on J.K. Scott.
Interesting. Two defenders back for Tennessee. Do they have a different looking return here? Maybe a reverse or something? Have not seen that.
No. Here's Scott. Not his best.
Oh, they're faking it to one side. It didn't work.
Whoa. That was Kamara back, and he did dance out of the way as the ball approached him. And we've got a little...
Didn't touch him. Josh Smith was kind of doing a gimmick return, trying to draw the defense to him, but it wasn't a good enough punt to return.
Time call. 13-10 to go, third quarter. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Outback Steakhouse, Geico, The Home Depot, and by DirecTV. There's the Vol Navy, began in 1962, and there's Joshua Dobbs. Tough day so far.
Well, yeah, I mean, the talk always has been a mobile quarterback gives Alabama's defense problems. That can be true if you have the guys around you to help. And this time, the offensive line has been overrun by this Alabama defense. Forced him into an interception on a screen pass up front. They've overpowered the offensive line. Same thing I looked at a week ago watching the Arkansas game. The front seven for Alabama just really destroyed the game plan for Arkansas. And in the second half, they started out really hot, the Alabama defense. They went three and out for minus 3 yards, an interception and interception to put the game away.
First down 10 here. And nothing doing on the left side. It's Alvin Kamara. And again, at the start of the game, the Vols had two offensive starters out with injuries, Jayshon Robertson and Dylan Wiseman. They've lost Brett Kendrick in this game. So you've got Coleman Thomas, Denzel Boulware, and Drew Richmond on that left side of the line. Second down, 9. Dobbs throws from Malone. But look at that. Four white shirts immediately surrounding.
Yeah, and that's, again, the difference between Alabama. We talked about it against A&M. Tennessee was able to throw these short passes, and they ended up with 314 yards after the catch. Today, they're getting gobbled up quickly.
Third down, 5. Blitz. Dobbs. Got it. First down at the 40-yard line.
Now, that was a courageous throw by Josh Dobbs. Maybe his best of the game. Pressure was coming in on him. He could feel it. Crossing route right over the middle. Remember, he has not thrown a lot over the middle of the field. This time delivers a good pass under pressure as he let it go.
Catch was made by Juwan Jennings. Now Hurd is back in the backfield. Hurd, 9 carries for 30 yards in the game. Goes left, nothing.
Man, as you say, nothing. I mean, I don't know how Ruben reads it that fast. I just don't know how he knows. Actually, it was a run stunt. He's coming in. That's a design run stunt. He was in there. And he's coming even right at the snap and expecting if it comes his way, he's right there. And he's fast enough, if it's not there, to chase it down from behind.
Leaves a second down, 11. There's the option pitch.
Look at him. Look at him. Whoa, that's the other guy. Number 20, Deion Hamilton. 10, 20, Doesn't matter. They're all elite athletes. Watch him run this down. Inside out. One bit of a mishap with the pitch, and Alabama eats it up.
Third down, 14. Bird gets alongside Joshua Dobbs. Four-man rush. Dobbs to Hurd. It'll be fourth down.
It's a tough throw. I mean, that's the second time in this game. Josh Dobbs took a two-yard pass on third and real long. I mean, there's no way that Jalen Hurd's going to catch a pass with his back to the defense and be able to get a first down from that situation. Maybe a crossing route, but not a back like that.
That brings on Trevor Daniel again. Eddie Jackson awaiting the punt at the 20-yard line. Ooh. Oh, dear.
Yep.
A shank.
That might be close to the 50-yard line. It was so bad. I don't even know if he gets a first down here.
My gosh.
Right at the 49-yard line.
Yeah, 49-yard line. A 16-yard punt. Out of bounds. Alabama dominated.
Hey, Evan. So, you stuck at a work thing.
Been a while since we've welcomed the Duck. I think it's appropriate to do so right now. The Aflac trivia question. Which former Alabama player, assistant coach under Bear Bryant, later became the head coach at Tennessee? When we tell you, you'll go, oh, yeah, I remember that.
Well, you're kidding like you don't know it. You got it yesterday. What are you doing?
Thank you. Well, I didn't want to.
All right, you had it. You nailed it.
Yeah, I did get it. I did.
Well, there's remember, Alabama's number one in the nation in plus 40-yard plays and plus 50-yard plays. Is this where Lane Kiffin does the old play-action pass bomb?
Oh, this one you mean. Across the middle, crossing pattern. Is that what you were talking about?
Well, it wasn't open deep, and he was smart enough to go. Watch our Darius Stewart feel the defender, grab this catch, and go inside. He doesn't fade away from the throw. Watch how he catches it and goes to meet the ball and then loses a half a yard. That is not taught. That is just an athlete being able to pluck it out.
And they'll test the left guard spot now, Damian Harris. That's his 13th carry of the ball game for 80 yards.
Last week against Arkansas, Alabama went over 500 yards in just 51 plays. The next snap for Alabama will be their 51st of the game, and we're midway through the third quarter.
Play action. Hurts under pressure, rolls out, throws it away.
He had Ridley, but a good pass rush that time. Couldn't get it off.
Colton Jumper was the fellow providing the pressure.
Yeah, all he does is make plays, Colton Jumper.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I admit, they got some good players out, not out there, but Colton Jumper is pulling his weight in this for this football team.
Darren Kirkland is the starter. He is one of three defensive starters unable to go. They expect him back soon, but Jumper has played really well in the last three, four games.
This is going to be close. Will they have to burn another timeout? I think they might have to here.
They did get it. Hurts. He's got two in front of him. Hello. Dragged down with a first and goal at the two-yard line.
It was very interesting there. It caught Tennessee off balance. Alabama had only 10 men on the field, and when they substituted, the official tried to slow the play down. Alabama very smartly snapped it with 1 second, and I don't think Tennessee was ready.
First and goal. Hurts gets a block, strolls in, untouched. Touchdown, Alabama. .902 to go in the third.
Trayvon Diggs, number 7. Stephon Diggs' brother, the All-American from Maryland, now playing for the Minnesota Vikings. Big block on that play.
Adam Griffith for the extra point.
Well, here's the sequence, Vern, of what happened. Alabama's confused. The clock was running down. Alabama substitutes late, so the officials are holding off the play. Just 4 seconds to go. Well, they get it going. They're snapping. As soon as the official backed up, it was almost like a quick snap, and Tennessee was really not set up to stop it. And then one play later, play action pass, block on the right side by Diggs, and a walk in by the quarterback.
Buy one, get one boneless wing.
I know, and I can never choose.
Welcome back to Neyland Stadium, where Alabama leads Tennessee 28-7. We talk about the passionate fans of the SEC all of the time, and this one is right there with the best of them. His name is Wesley McNeely. And the reason we're showing Wesley is not because he hasn't missed a home game in over a decade, but he was celebrating the amazing Hail Mary pass against Georgia, and he was celebrating so hard that he broke his ankle. He avoided having surgery. That way he could travel to Texas A&M for the game. He got surgery this week on Tuesday, and he is here, as promised, to not miss a single home game this season. Gary overheard him talking in the airport, challenged me to find him, and we officially found him. Gary, there's Wesley for you.
Yeah, the only thing I didn't like because he was in front of me in the Starbucks landing, going really slow. That's how I noticed him.
Here is the return from Evan Berry. Nice. Well, Tennessee has not had anything going offensively. Look at this. Punt interception, punt, punt, touchdown after a fumble, punt, punt, punt.
You know, when you have 41 plays, 53 yards, those are always really ugly, and that's a bad possession chart right there. And a great defense. If you don't bring it against this defense, Alabama doesn't beat themselves. You have to have precision throwing the ball, pass blocking, running. They just don't beat themselves, especially on defense.
Joshua Dobbs handed off on the sweep. Tyler Bird, the freshman from Naples, Florida. Rashawn Evans makes the stop here.
Well, you know, we did the game just a week ago. Tennessee trailed that game 28-7. Just a different feel, though. The offense, like we talked about it, the offense was gaining yards but turning it over. Here, they just can't find yards. Big difference in the feel. Let's see. A couple first downs, maybe it'll change.
Here's Dobbs. Got Ethan Wolf. And he breaks, well, he can't break the tackle, but he does get a couple of extra yards.
Yeah, great read that time by Josh Dobbs. Looked out wide like it was a wide receiver screen to the outside, and Ethan Wolf gets into the middle of the field. Easy pitch and catch.
Now Hurd is the running back behind Dobbs. There's Ethan Wolf. Sets up on the left side. Hurd. Sean Dion Hamilton with the tackle. Jalen Hurd missed last week's game. He's now replaced by Kamara. Kamara's been held in check, too. He ran wild against A&M. But so far in this game, 7 carries for 18 yards. And only 2 catches. Dobbs caught at the 35. Josh Smith.
Remember, we talked about how you have to be precise against Alabama. A great route by Josh Smith here. He goes out on the stem, comes back, ball to the outside. If you're going to go to run and beat this defense, you have to run precise routes, and that was.
Stacked receivers on either side of the ball. Dobbs. And for the day, Dobbs is now rushed 6 times, negative yards. Christian Miller with the tackle this time.
Yes, Alabama continues to get their second line players in. They've been a great improvement in Alabama as the spread tempo teams. Alabama's got better at getting their rolling their second line players into the game. Christian Miller comes in fresh and makes the tackle.
Malone across the backfield, wide to the left. Dobbs looks that direction. He's got him wide open. And Malone around the defender, Anthony Averett, and picks up another first down.
I think this time the Alabama defense was a bit confused. Two guys going deep, and they had double covered the slot, but I don't know why Anthony Averett was bailing on that play. He should have had a man-to-man a little tighter.
Gain of 12, first down, Tennessee. And they'll drive it up the middle. Alvin Kamara. Well, Kirby Smart was the defensive coordinator last year, and Jeremy Pruitt has taken his place. And the rankings haven't changed much,
no,
have they?
Seems like Kirby Smart, watching his Georgia team this year, he was a much better coach last year.
Are you suggesting
the good players?
Quality of players? Yeah, maybe. And, of course, Georgia took it on the chin today. 17-16. Whoa!
Same play that he hit Ethan Wolf over the middle. Exact same play. This time he threw it out to the back, and Alabama does not let you throw those short passes. See the middle? They had the guy in the middle again. Dobbs made his mind up that time. He figured Alabama would cover the same guy over the middle. They did not. He could have gone to the middle and got the same game.
Eddie Jackson with the stop for the Crimson Tide. Third down, 10. Pressure coming. They pass it to Juwan Jennings.
Juwan Jennings comes up with more 50-50 balls than any receiver in this league. As tough as you can be. Fourth down and 5. But he hangs and he fights, and you're not going to outfight him for a football. Good coverage by Micah Fitzpatrick, though. When you have 3rd and 10 and you give up a 5-yard pass, that's a win.
Aaron Medley will try to tack 3 on 4th down and 6. This is a 37-yard field goal effort for Medley. Snap a little high, but controlled and right down the middle. Finally, something for Tennessee offensively. Time call. Medley. And they'll take a knee. Let's get the duck back at center stage. And the answer to the Aflac trivia question, which former Alabama player and assistant coach under Bear Bryant later became head coach of Tennessee? Bill Battle. Saw Bill, the athletic director at Alabama, for the game. There's a list of those on both sides of the rivalry. Dave Hart, AD now at Tennessee. Lane Kiffin, of course, 1 year the head coach here. Kind of a memorable year. Derek Ansley, Mike Vollmer. And here come the Crimson Tide. Lane Kiffin.
Of course, the headliner is Lane Kiffin.
Yes. I would think so.
Deservedly so.
Yeah, 1 year. And then famously left to take the USC job. Here's Hurts. Deep left side, double coverage. He's got it. That's Calvin Ridley.
Yeah, you know it on first down. Pretty soon, Calvin Ridley looked like he was going to go to the post. Very patient route. Watch him come in and then out to a deep flag right here. Alabama throws a lot of post routes. This time he's got a safety, bracket him to the outside, and a perfect throw from Jalen Hurts.
Gain of 31. Damian Harris bounces off the tackle and battles his way inside the 30, just inside the 30. 340 to go, 341.
And I think Mixon, number 40, is down on the field as Alabama continues to show you that they're going to continue to run inside and play action pass. That's their team this year. Was it 39? I'm sorry, Vickers?
Yeah, Kendall Vickers.
Yes. Well, last week's game, Tennessee had 8 different players during the game that had to leave the field with an injury like that. It was a long game because of that, too.
Matter of fact, the game time was 4 hours and 42 minutes. This is Kendall Vickers, Jr. And while the medical staff is out taking care of him, we'll step aside. Kendall Vickers, there's the pitch to Calvin Ridley. He goes around the right side.
And of course, that counts as a pass, and the receivers actually like, instead of handing it to him, since they catch so many balls, that's actually safer than handing it to him. They're used to catching the ball in the air. It counts as a pass. I'd like it if I was a QB.
Well, I'd like it if I was a receiver.
That's right.
The stats go up.
Another one, the other way.
Yeah.
For this Heisman watch presented by the new Nissan Titan.
All right, Vern, Deshaun Watson and Clemson, they were tested by NC State today. 4 turnovers as a team, but in overtime, Watson to Artavis Scott for what would be the winning score. JT Barrett coming off a rough passing day leads the Buckeyes. Madison for a Big Ten top 10 showdown. Christian McCaffrey out tonight against Notre Dame.
Bo Scarborough got the handoff and got inside the 20. 10, 15 seconds. Obviously working on that. Apologies. First down, 10. 28-10. Joshua Jacobs is the running back. Stewart and Ridley.
No bad read.
Oh, yes. Deshaun Golden all over that one.
Yeah, that ball could have gone up inside. Joshua Jacobs, the young running back, going left. Watch the end come up top. Golden's right there to the outside, makes a good play and forces him. Should have gone inside of O.J. Howard's block, and he did not.
That's Vickers getting the tape job on the Tennessee bench. Trayvon Diggs in the backfield now, number 7, comes in motion. Hurts steps up. Wow, wide open. O.J. Howard down at the 1.
Well, I'll tell you, everybody that watches Alabama says, how can the guy that was the hero of the national championship game not get more targets? Lane gets very upset when people say that to him. That's his 20th target. He's got 14 receptions. That's pretty good.
Jacobs is the running back now. First down goal. Hurts rolls out. Looks. Says, what the heck? I'll just run it in for the 3rd touchdown on the ground today.
That was somewhat of a sarcastic look at the camera there. Like, are you kidding me? You're trying to tackle me with that? Just kind of stared and went, you do a field goal, I drive it down the field. Watch this. 1 player to the outside, you don't have a chance. Man. And he goes into the camera. That qualifies, doesn't it? Sarcastic? Like, no chance to get me?
Yeah.
What did you think?
Well, yes. It was a sarcastic look.
Yes.
I'm still looking for the lane kick. It's man versus millennial in the great indoors. Joel McHale stars in the new comedy premiering Thursday, October 27th, only CBS. .35-10. Final 49 seconds, third quarter.
Mern, this is the third time in 5 years as we look at that last touchdown pass play. At least Lane thought it was going to be a touchdown play, just short. You know, and Lane is good at sarcastic, let me just tell you that.
Yeah.
He's really good at it.
I wouldn't disagree with that at all. Through the end zone. And a touchback. Jalen Hurts, Channel View, Texas, in the Houston area.
Just think about it. High school football player a year ago, watching Alabama play football for the national championship. A five-star number one recruit. Blake Barnett was ahead of him, redshirting. He still accepts the challenge to go to Alabama, comes in for spring football, and wins the job.
And Blake Barnett decides to transfer. First down 10, Tennessee, 49 seconds to go, third quarter. Dobbs comes the pressure. It's incomplete.
As I was going to point out, this is the third time in 5 years Tennessee has played Alabama, as Alabama has been the number one team in the nation. The past two, they lost by 35, and they lost by 31. They're down by 25.
Joshua Dobbs now 13 of 24 for a modest 82 yards. And he keeps this one, goes around the left side, Sean Dion Hamilton. That's Dobbs' seventh carry, still negative yards, minus 31. Again in college ball, sacks come off rushing yardage. I thought I might be around working long enough until they change that, but I guess it ain't going to happen.
You should have said make it correct.
Yeah.
Instead of change, make it the way it should be.
Here comes the rush. Dobbs gets hit as he lets it go. Catch is made out on the right side by Tyler Byrd. Marlon Humphrey was there.
And the Alabama defensive backs know that with that five-man rush up front, they don't have to back up one step. They just have it thrown in front of them, and they play physical tackle on the catch.
End of the third quarter. We'll return to Knoxville after this message and a word from your local station.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Well, the adrenaline thus far, all for Alabama as they lead 38-10. You see the score by quarter, 35-10. This is the seventh consecutive game the Crimson Tide has gone north of 30 points. The fewest points they've scored this year, 34.
And you got a great chance of going over 500 yards again.
Yes.
Done it twice. I think they had 499 yards in one game.
Ninth punt, Trevor Daniel. Eddie Jackson. Have I mentioned, this is Eddie Jackson. Touchdown, Crimson Tide.
I guess that's what it happens when you have six consecutive number one recruiting classes in a row. The Alabama X's are just better than the Tennessee O's.
My oh my. Touchdown, 41-10.
Just watch him. He wants a touchdown. Watch him judge the, as you see the chicken, watch him judge the coverage. As the ball's in the air, he looks up, then he looks down. I'll take it. He looks down twice, and then he goes for it. Makes one guy miss, and nobody's going to catch him. A high school wide receiver with ball skills, exactly what Nick Saban likes to recruit.
Another non-offensive touchdown.
And now it's time for our Geico game recap.
Well, let's take you through what's happened thus far. The ninth straight game with a non-offensive touchdown. This was Ronnie Harrison with the interception and the return. It's also the fourth straight game for Tennessee, trailing by 10 or more at the half. It was Ardarius Stewart on the reverse, adding to the Alabama total. They did cut it to 14-7, and Jalen Hurts, this is too obvious. He's hurt them. I'm sorry.
In a lot of ways, and there's been a lot of Hurts putting on a lot of guys with this defense as well.
In the meantime, we've not heard that much from Tennessee. Eddie Jackson just a moment ago, 79th punt return with a touchdown. Gary refers to these as NOTS, N-O-T-S, as the acronym for non-offensive touchdown.
Well, and remember, right now, Alabama's defensive scoring and special team scoring is outscoring Tennessee's offense, 14-10.
The kick from Griffith. And let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Hey, Vern, a couple injury updates for you. Tyler Bird was limping pretty badly on the sideline. He went to the athletic trainer's table. They worked on his left knee, but they did hand him back his helmet, and he appears to be going in. Evan Berry is on the trainer's table right now, getting his left ankle retaped.
All right, Allie. Josh Dobbs, 14 of 25 for 83. Leading receiver is Ethan Wolf, 2 for 30 yards. Juwan Jennings has caught 3, but only for 20 yards. Here's Dobbs. And he finds Malone out to the 31-yard line.
Go ahead, Vern.
No. Please, Gary.
We just were talking again about matching up. How do you match up? Tennessee has a talented football team, but a lot of them are not playing, including three of their key players. Might be their three best defensive players of four with Derek Barnett are not playing in the game. Tough to match up for Tennessee. Will they be back this season as Tennessee tries to get back in the hunt in the East? Because right now, Florida, if they don't come back, Tennessee in this game will control their own destiny.
Third down, 4. Volunteers after this devilish stretch of 4 consecutive games do have an open week next week. Alabama returns home against the undefeated Aggies of Texas A&M. Here comes the rush. Dobbs heads right, comes back across the body, completes it, and they hustle toward the first down line. It's Josh Malone.
This is the time when Nick Saban really grinds the most. He'll have his team a big lead. He knows there's some bit of complacency with the football team. He's got his backups in there right now. Christian Miller's on the field, along with Jonathan Allen. He kind of spots them in one at a time. But as Tennessee decides they're going to punt here, you'll hear the crowd.
Yeah. And this crowd is emptying out.
Let's see if Tennessee has something, though. I would assume Alabama will keep their defense safe on the field. Yes, they have.
Nice, high, and deep, and a fair catch called for and taken at the 14-yard line by Eddie Jackson. 12 minutes, 37 seconds to go. Crimson Tide is rolling. Years Goodyear has provided aerial coverage of college football's greatest traditions and biggest rivalries.
One of the things that Nick Saban was upset with as we look at Jalen Hurts with his defense is they had too many plays, 84 plays as a defense. He said we couldn't get off the field. When will Nick Saban start resting his players for the big game next week against Texas A&M.
Hurts. Ardarius Stewart, Emmanuel Mosley with the tackle. This was Jalen Hurts when they arrived.
Oh. Got a good laugh out of it.
Yeah. Second down and 9. Here we go.
New big post Scarborough.
Here we go. They've got an angle on him. Can he keep going?
Wow.
Yes.
Oh, he can. Defender pulled up lame.
Micah Abernathy, Scarborough, 85 yards.
Right to the left side. Oh, nice block up there by Ross Piersbacher, number 71. Came off late, sealed it. Watch Abernathy pull up. He's got a chance and pulls up lane right at the end of the run.
Hamstring.
That's a big man running that fast down the sideline. You see why so many Alabama people were excited about his ability.
Micah Abernathy. Up and limping as he comes to the near side.
Did think when I watched him against Arkansas, he might have finally found it. He struggled early in the year, a little bit with expectations of being the guy this year. I thought he ran well against Arkansas. And look at him. Look at the ability he has to pull away. Like Derrick Henry running down the sideline,
sure
didn't it?
Sure did. And he, as you said, is a large human being. 6'2", 228. Let's go back and look at the end of the play.
Need to do that. Not
that
necessary.
Is so unnecessary.
He was actually, it probably has Alabama A on his glove, and he probably was putting the A right into the face of the, and I'm surprised the official did not call it for unnecessary, not unnecessary, excessive celebration.
Well, the guy's got on Peyton Manning's old jersey. Here's Scarborough. Not pretty at the end.
More than 400 yards in his football game.
Griffith. Tyler Bird. Near the 28-yard line. Another return. Well, let's take a look at the SEC East standings. Tennessee came in tied with Florida. Florida, as Adam told you, is up on Missouri. Tennessee getting manhandled here at home. Georgia lost to Vanderbilt today. And we've got a new quarterback, Quentin Dormady, has replaced Josh Dobbs. It just wasn't there for Joshua today. 16 of 27 for 92 yards and 7 rushes for minus 31. Dormady, right side. Come back, got it. Josh Malone. Big first play. That's the first pass attempted or completed by Dormady this season.
Well, they are letting the receivers, Joshua with the defensive backs. Good coverage, overrun, and half a shove by against Fitzpatrick, and they're letting them play. They've been doing that all game, both ways.
John Kelly is the running back now. He had a very good game last week in that double overtime loss at A&M. Kelly. And Joshua Dobbs just not to be today.
Yeah, he needed more help. He's not a drop back passer. He's not one of those guys going to stand in the pocket and hurt you with the passing game. He needed help in the running game, and he needed to provide help with his legs. Alabama shut him down in the run game.
Second down, 7, Dermody. Behind the intended receiver, John Kelly. Dermody, a sophomore out of Bernie, Texas, not that far from San Antonio. Last season, 13 of 22 for 209 yards, one TD.
Alabama has kept a lot of their secondary in the game, but the front four and linebackers have their backups.
Blitz hit him. John Kelly catches him and is hurled out of bounds. And the clock stopped at 10:06 to go. Dormady's a tall lad, a 6'4", 216-pound sophomore.
Yeah, more pocket passer, not the running type. Here's a fourth down call to see if Alabama can get off the field or Tennessee can keep the drive ahead going. Same look. Three-man front, but they'll rush five.
Dormady, this one's tipped away. Ronnie Harrison.
And again, Alabama just does not fear any deep balls. They jump on everything. When you try to make a break, you cut them out of your break. Number 15 won't back up. Why would I want to back up? I know my guys are going to get your quarterback within a second and a half. I'm going to stay right on you.
9:36 to go in this one.
We've worked pretty hard to become the world's largest in...
It's a late show you can't miss.
The freshman quarterback, Jalen Hurts, is through for the day. And what a day it was. This was a 45-yard touchdown run. One of three that he has scored. The last two kind of eased on in. You can't stop me. Jalen Hurts on the ground, 132 yards on 12 carries.
You know, I was watching him, and he has, as we talked about at the beginning, great composure. I think that's his strongest attribute to play. Great speed, kind of like Blake Sims' speed. Remember, because Blake was a running back. I think he's got the arm strength of A.J. McCarron, and I think he's got the brain of Greg McElroy. I only did that to get Greg McElroy mad, because you know he will be mad, won't you?
No, I thought he was a really good game manager. Of course
I said the brain of...
Here we go.
You mean the Greg McElroy of the... I once said, you're going to run an NFL team before it's all done. Well, Greg is one of our favorites.
I do always say, though, it's hard as Cooper Bakeman comes in the game as the new backup quarterback. And remember, Cooper started a game a year ago against Ole Miss. Is it going to be a walk for Alabama all the way? I mean, every championship they've had that tight game. As we talked about Greg McElroy, that game against Auburn. A.J. McCarron, Blake Sims had the game against LSU, and of course Jake Coker did it against his Tennessee team a year ago. Don't you have the feeling there's going to be that one game that it's going to be at the end, the quarterback is going to have to find a way to win the game?
That carry from B.J. Emmons, and here is the Alabama schedule. They only scored 34 against Kentucky. Look at the margin of difference with the exception of the come-from-behind win at Ole Miss. And yeah. Then what's next?
Next week, Texas A&M coming to town. Two undefeated football teams with a quarterback who the Alabama fans know.
That would be Trevor Knight. Great guard Diggs, yeah.
Backup offensive line in the game.
This is Diggs. Well, Trevor Knight now at Texas A&M, where he has really been a solid leader. He began his collegiate career at Oklahoma. And look at the game he had, Gary, in the Sugar Bowl against Alabama.
He made the deep throws. He made the athletic throws. And even when Alabama had guys covered, Trevor Knight that night was on fire. He was it was almost a few times I thought he was throwing it right down the chimney. You know, the throw lob to the outside. He is a good deep thrower, very athletic, but he's got some receivers at A&M that will challenge Alabama next week.
First down 10. This is B.J. Emmons, the fourth running back used. And let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Hey, Vern, I've been watching Jalen Hurts on the sideline, and he is the definition of calm, cool, and collected. Very similar to Josh Dobbs, except for it's exceptional because of his youth. Coach Saban told us absolutely nothing phases Jalen Hurts, and you can see it down here on the sideline. One of the things that O.J. Howard told me this week is that he has a veteran presence, and he's growing in that each week, and that the team is really buying into it. At first, he was lacking some of the vocal leadership, but he's really picking up on it, and he's been vocal all game today.
Well, he has led the Crimson Tide, not so much in passing, but Gary made it 400 yards.
We knew it was coming.
Rushing.
And what? How about the story Nick told about Jalen, his first play fumbling, right?
That's right.
He said, if I'd have done that, I don't know if I could have survived that when I was in college. First play of the season, his first against USC. He fumbled it. Nick watched him and actually thought more of him the way he handled it. He said nothing fazes him. Got to admit, though, he does have the benefit of having a defense that he does not have to press the throws. You know, a punt for Alabama puts that game-breaking defense and punt return team on the field.
Well, it's way too early. Way too early, but it's still worth mentioning. The last time a freshman quarterback led a team to the national championship, 1985, University of Oklahoma. That quarterback, Jamel Holloway. Take you back to that 85 season. Holloway became the first true freshman honored quarterback to lead his team. The Sooners went 11-1 that year and beat Penn State in the Orange Bowl and captured the title.
Rumbling, stumbling Keith Jackson caught pass right
there. Yes. And that stumbling, bumbling tight end is doing radio for Arkansas.
There's
a fumble and a bumble.
He picked it up. Made
Scarborough,
a first down.
Yeah. When it's going your way.
You know how Jamel Holloway got his ability to start that season in 1985 for Oklahoma?
I don't remember.
As you watch the fumble being recovered?
Yeah.
Troy Aikman got hurt. Never got his job back.
And wound up
at UCLA.
Yeah, he transferred to UCLA. Sat out. That's the first year I met Rick Neuheiser. Was when Troy was there.
Whatever happened to him?
I don't know.
I think he went into music.
Took a guitar.
Yes, right.
You know, cutting chords. Right, B.J. Emmons. Well, coming up shortly, we've got a plethora of options here. The Napa play of the game. I've got a feeling we're going to hear from our old friend Eli Gold, the Alabama radio announcer, who was inducted into the Alabama Hall of Fame earlier.
So Tennessee has lost controlling the East now.
Yes.
Florida, we talked about it, is going to control the East. And the big change is, instead of having that home game against LSU that they've already played, they're going to play it as control now. They lost, they're going to play at LSU.
Second down, 11. 4 minutes to go. B.J. Emmons. Well, Tennessee will end this four-game stretch that has been really a tough one. They'll win two and lose two. Florida, Georgia, then the Aggies in Alabama. They've got an open date. And every game, I believe, on the remainder of their schedule is winnable.
Well, more than winnable. They have better talent than the people they're going to play at the end of their schedule. They should win them all. And they've got a hope for Florida to lose one football game, and they would go to Atlanta.
First down, 10. Emmons. White get around the corner.
Lewis carry.
Well, Alabama inside the red zone today. Two touchdowns, 2 of 4. And those are the Verizon red zone stats for the Alabama offense this afternoon. And the clock under 3 minutes to go.
I will say this, if Tennessee is in this bye week, if they're going to make that run and finish winning the rest of the games, they need to get a little bit more healthy.
Yeah, they do. Some will be back, not all. And here's Bateman. Loses yardage back to the 12. Emmanuel Mosley makes the stop.
I thought that if Tennessee lost this game, and it was a well-fought game, that even with two losses, if they ran the table, let's say they run the table, Florida loses, and they avenge the loss to Alabama. So let's say Alabama's in the championship. I thought they would have a strong argument for still getting there. They have the second toughest schedule right now as they stand after this game. But this loss this big is going to hurt that argument.
Gosh.
Louisville is going to stand up and say, that can't happen. It's going to be very interesting. Let's suppose the SEC champion has two losses.
Mm-hmm. Well, fourth down, 49-10. And the Jeep postgame show will be coming up when we put this one to bed, which is in 93 seconds of actual playing time. Nick Saban, his team about to win their 19th in succession. They will extend the victory string over Tennessee to 10 games in succession. And a tough one for Butch Jones and the Volunteers. Losing, okay, but losing in this fashion.
And it wasn't close. They just were not as good as Alabama.
Emmons on the corner gets a good block. It's fourth down. And the ball will go over on downs on the change. How about this? First time with 400 yards rushing against the green wave of Tulane 24 years ago.
Since 2008, basically, we've been watching the excellence of Nick Saban's teams, and this one just looks so different. You know, it's the same type of defense, but it's just a totally different look on offense, and they're powerful. They force you to stop 11 players on offense, and they're going to be a tough out for anybody here.
Tennessee in the final 50 seconds to go. John Curry gets out. They are so strong on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, I don't think they're quite as deep. I think their front 11 on defense is as good as they've ever been. I don't think they're second level like they had last year. I mean, they just rolled in guys. They could play 10 guys up front. I don't think they're quite as deep, but their pass rush. There's no college team that has their pass rush.
This one over the right tackle spot. John Kelly gets it. And here comes Nick Saban. Here comes Butch Jones. An absolute total domination by Alabama. Eddie Jackson with a punt return for a touchdown. Let's go down to Alley with Nick Saban.
Coach, no team has been able to slow down Tennessee in the second half. Not only did you slow them down, you shut them down. What are you most impressed with this big win today?
Well, I think our defense really responded to what happened last week and played great today. And offense did a good job of putting a lot of points on the board and scored on defense and had a great punt return. So we wanted to play a complete game, and I'm really proud of the way our guys did that.
Your team now has 11 non-offensive touchdowns. It's the most in any season under you, and we're only halfway through this year. Your defense has been so impressive.
Well, you know, you want to play great on special teams, and we got some guys that can make plays on defense and affect the quarterback. And, you know, we've been able to make those plays. I just hope they keep coming.
Thank you, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And it is time for the Napa play of the game. We'll go back to